evident if we look over just the last year, the records that were broken. For example, May and June were the wettest two consecutive months ever recorded, and overall 2012 was the warmest year recorded. And as we see these changes in weather, we see an increasing extreme weather events. This map shows that by September of 2011, every single county in the state of Vermont had announced a FEMA declaration, a disaster declaration, and so the issue is widespread and costly. And looking at Irene, just since the 2 years of this event, we've received over $565 million in federal and state support for recovery, which if you compare to Vermont's per capita income, it would be equivalent to over our income in the time of the year. So we're studying how Vermont is preparing and what type of adaptation planning is effective. A lot of the town or the planning is happening at the town level. Unfortunately, very few towns have adopted hazard mitigation plans or updated flood zoning regulations. And additionally, the planning at the town level doesn't match the boundaries that are required for building systems of resilience. So this map shows 18 watersheds throughout Vermont. And as you can see, when we're talking about responding to weather impacts, we need to think about geographic regions. And so the watersheds here don't align with town boundaries. And it would require a multitude of towns to cooperate together to create effective strategies. And if you think about some of our other institutions, like our transportation system, you know, what would it look like if we stopped our transportation planning at town borders? Or if our education systems didn't include regional high schools around Vermont to provide for education for small rural communities. So we have to start thinking about building resilience in these same type of systems. And so what I've done with my work is to look at one area in particular where they've been very progressive in adaptation planning. This is the Matter Row Valley, located in central Vermont, which is comprised of four towns. Last year, there were one of five communities in the entire country that received a grant supported by the EPA. And they've worked, their community groups and their planning district worked with Vermont agencies to come up with recommendations to prepare for future flooding. They've also worked with the Vermont Land Trust, and again, through various volunteer community groups and regional collaboration, have conserved over 15% of the floodplain in the area. And Wakesville has adopted fluvial erosion hazard overlay in their town plan. Warren is supposed to do so at the end of the year. And what's really impressive about this work is that the decisions being made in these towns are actually protecting the downtown village of Moortown, which is downstream. So my work will continue to look at successes like these so we can better understand and communicate throughout the rest of Vermont to implement these strategies more effectively, building capacity at the regional and watershed.